You are a bold and courageous person, afraid of nothing. Once, as a child, you were frightened by a huge snarling dog. You have hated and feared dogs all your life.
Hello everyone, this is part 3 of my soundtrack collection. Though these particular albums aren't actually movie soundtracks, I felt that I'd include them into this little series. Right here, some of you guys might recognize this, Walt Disney Studios' chilling, thrilling sounds of the Haunted House. Flip onto the back here. Some more artwork. Features various sound effects. Perhaps you can hear it going on behind me. My particular version I bought came out in 1979. I've seen a lot of websites that put this at 78, but according to the copyright on the back, it says 79, has copyright publishing dates. The first one of these albums to come out was in 1963. And it actually had a storytelling. I think it was on side A, and you had like a woman telling a story complete with sound effects. On side B, you didn't have a story, you just had the sound effects. And the idea was that you would create your own story to go along with the sound effects. Now on this album, there isn't any stories, it's just all various kind of creaking and witch cackling, ghosts howling and dogs barking and cats screeching and fighting, that kind of stuff. But it's a neat little album. I know a lot of kids had this when I was younger. I always wanted one, but I never got one. I got lucky. I picked this up for pretty cheap. Only 99 cents. I was kind of surprised. And when I found this, this album here was right behind it, or it was right in front of it. I don't remember which now, but they were right next to each other. Both of them were running 99 cents. I was kind of surprised. I was happy, so I grabbed both of them. This is called Famous Monsters Speak. When I saw the title, I got a little confused. Of course, I'm familiar with Famous Monsters of Filmland, the magazine, which started in the late 50s. This album came out around 63, I think. Actually, I think I said the first one of these came out in 63. I think it was 64, actually. But this came out in 63, using the Famous Monsters, Frankenstein and Dracula, trying to cash in on that monster craze that was happening during the late 50s and early 60s. People grew up in that era, kind of called monster kids. Hold on a second here. Wanted to turn the sounds down behind me. It's kind of distracting me a little bit. But this is it's kind of cool for what it is. It's not terribly interesting to listen to. You got some of your other catalog items here. But on one side you have Frankenstein, and basically they've hooked up, you get to hear what his thoughts were kind of during those last days, and basically he's kind of an intelligent being but trapped in this monstrous body that nobody can understand. So you get to hear what his thoughts are like, he's being kind of chased around, wishing he could just communicate. The Dracula one's a little more straightforward as someone visits a sinister count himself. Hopefully his names come in. Written by Cherny Berg, the voices of Gabriel Dell. You also see the Wolfman, the Gill Man, the Creature, and the Mummy, but they're not on this album. But their images have graced the cover. Over here, Drop Dead, an exercise in horror, Arch Oboler. Onto the back. Lights out, everyone. Arch Oboler was a writer, wrote plays, wrote radio scripts and television scripts, but he's probably best known for the Lights Out radio program. For TV, people could sit around and listen to various kind of adventures and dramas and other things, and he signed on board for a horror one. He didn't create it, but he came on afterwards. Became quite popular. But there was a time period when some of these old radio dramas were being released on albums, which obviously I have right here. Yeah, Sorry, I don't know the copyright date. I was trying to see how old this particular release was, but I don't know off the top of my head. But the most famous story on here is the chicken heart. It's about a chicken heart. Starts out normal, and it keeps growing, and it keeps growing, and it keeps growing. It's unstoppable. Finally grows, overtakes the whole face of the earth. It can't be stopped. Thump, thump. Thump, thump. Thump, thump. A lot of people probably heard of the chicken heart thanks to Bill Cosby. The bit had left such an impact on him, they actually included it in his stand-up routines. And, in fact, when he started doing Fat Albert, there's actually an episode of Fat Albert and the Cosby Kids that features the chicken heart. And I think it's a young Bill, who they're like at a camp or something, people are sitting around a campfire, and he actually tells the story of the chicken heart. And you get to see it in animated form. But a lot of people kind of know chicken heart thanks to Bill Cosby. It kind of survived because of him. But this is Drop Dead, Next Size in Horror. And sticking with Lights Out, I have another one that was released onto vinyl, Lights Out, which just features Murder Castle, exactly as heard on CBS, August 3rd, 1943. On the other side is The Witch's Tale, 1939 Program 2, Four Fingers and a Thumb. You can see from the artwork right there. I haven't listened to this in a long time. I couldn't really give you the synopsis on what the stories are. Obviously, a couple of horror tales. I think Lights Out actually used to come on at midnight. So an appropriate time to turn your lights out and listen to some scary tales. But kind of cool. And that's pretty much it. I do have a bunch of film soundtracks on CDs. I think I might do a quick additional video showing what I have on CDs. I probably won't go in depth. I was probably to show you what I got, kind of flip through the selection right quick. But this finishes off my album collection as far as the non-music stuff. And even though this isn't music, I did kind of want to show this. Since my last videos were featuring music and soundtracks, I figured I'd take this opportunity to show off two of my guitars, both of them Ibanez guitars. Quite nice, quite pretty, play very well. Kind of an intermediate okay guitar player myself. But as you look at this, I thank you for watching part 3. Hopefully you guys will come back and watch some of my other videos or watch videos I already have posted up. So thank you very much for watching this.
You remember some time ago in an Eastern scientific institution, they kept a piece of heart alive for weeks on end? Well, I got to thinking, what if that heart began to grow? And grow, and grow, and grow?
Hello? Hello, operator. Give me Mr. Regan, fast. Hello, Mr. Regan, this is Lewis. Listen, get me a rewrite, man. The thing's still growing. No, Chief, I tell you the truth. The corridor's choked with living, crawling flesh. No, I'm not drunk. I'm telling you.